Hanuman Jayanti is a Hindu religious festival that marks the birth of Lord Sri Hanuman, who is known as one of the biggest devotees of Lord Ram and a Rudra avatar. As we count down the days to this auspicious event, we will be bringing to you tales of Sri Hanuman and, of course, his birth story. This will be presented by Pandit Narad Gosain. Do enjoy. Jai Sri Hanuman.
Beautifully in our scripture, it is said, after walking around, after circumambulation, after prostrating, my dear bhaktas, to none other than that wonderful tree, a voice is about to be heard, and that voice is about to give word now. The voice is, Anjani, look up at the top of that branch there. There's one particular fruit, one particular mango that you're seeing. It's full of glow. It's glowing. Today, I will bring that fruit to you. Do you know why it is glowing? Because that fruit was specially blessed by Bhagavan Shankar. He placed his energy, he placed his light into that fruit. And if you partake of that fruit, that is the divine child you're looking for. A child will be conceived. The mother puts her hands together and she waits. And she's only seeing this big bright light. It is shining. The light in itself, like a star, it goes up to the fruit. It brings back down that fruit. And Kesari with hands together, heart to jod, he's looking at the entire episode that is taking place. And while the fruit is given into the hands of Kesari and Anjani Mata, they're holding that fruit in their hand, but the light is too bright, they cannot see who's there. They are now saying, Great One, Lord, Prabhu, can you please disclose yourself? Can you please show your true identity to us? Can you please not hide who you are? We want to know how to show gratitude towards you because of what you've done for us today. Can you please show us who you are? Devotees of God, are you your real identity? Are you really who you claim to say you are? Are you the real person that you tell people you are? Or are you two-faced people? There are people in the world who are two-faced and they come and laugh at you now and next minute, Jai Bhagwan. There are many people who are walking up to you and they're looking at you and they would smile with you and they would hug you and say, you know what, I wish you well. And they turn around, Hari Narayan. Naga Devata. Kya baat? Some of the older folks say they like snake. They come and they laugh at you and you turn around and they're ready to sting you. Two-faced people, do not be like that. Be your true identity. Mahavir Swami, because of his true identity, because of becoming one with himself, because of awakening his true nature, he became manifested with his most powerful form. You can do the same. Don't try to be anything else but who you are. Kesari says, I want to show gratitude to you. I want to be thankful to you. I want to show appreciation to you. Recently, I was mentioning to some devotees, do you know how hard it is for people to tell somebody thanks? Do you know how hard it is for somebody to come and say, here, you know, Vedu, thank you. Those words are the hardest. Some people say, well, he know now. Don't worry, he know. But words by itself can correct so many things. Words like saying thank you means a million to people. Words like saying sorry means a million to people. Words, my friends, like these can uplift, can mend things, can mend relationships, can mend a home, can bring back a community together just by saying simple words like thank you or sorry. Be your true self because your true self is humble like Lord Hanumanji. And a humble person will never stand up to fight back. A humble person will always destroy that ego and never feel that he or she is too big or bigger than anybody else. They are willing to simply tell the world, thank you. That is why they will get up and pray and say, Lord, thank you. They will never be ashamed of standing up in public and even saying to anybody, you know what, you see what you do? Thank you so much. Because it goes a long way. Show your identity, Kesari says. I simply want to show my gratitude. And when he speaks like this, it is said the light is becoming dim and an image is about to be seen.
Vayudeva Vanaravira Vayudeva Vanaravira.
He's Vayudev and he stands there. He's the wind god and he's Vayudev And he stands, and you can see the light dimming, and you can see standing there. And while he stands now, he says, you couldn't have seen me, because you know what? You were seeing my energy, my aura, my strength, my divinity. You couldn't have seen me. But today, I am Vayudev, and I will be a part of bringing this child in the world. Kesari, Anjani, let me let both of you know, if any day you need my help to guide this child, I will be there. That is why he is also called Pavana Putra. He is Pavana Putra Mahavir. He is the son of the wind god. And he was given that role, my friends, to protect this child. Now the mother and the father, they've turned around, they've prostrated, and they have gone back to their home. And while going back into their homes now, according to the Sri Hanuman Ankh, a chaupai as such goes like this.
करते न परपति देखी कैसे भ्राता पिता भूरो निज मन जैसे श्री राम जय राम जय हो बिनु आवसर बयते ही जो जनही हो आत्म नारी जग तो ये राम जय राम जय हो श्री राम जय राम जय जय रामा श्री राम जय रामा जय जय रामा
Be sure to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel and find us on Facebook at Sankhya Television.